to Struan. Thank you, Struan.
Thank you, Leslie Ann. Yeah, and I was just going to check that you were recording the session so that colleagues can catch up later if need be. So that's great. And as Leslie Ann says, yeah, please put any questions you have in the Q&A box or in the chat box, and I'll make sure I leave time at the end of the session to answer those. So what we're going to look at today, I'm just going to shut my camera down so I can see more of the screen. So what we are going to look at today is, I'm going to run through a bit of a demo that I usually run for Compass Plus users who've upgraded, where we run through a series of principles to help you get the most out of using Compass Plus. This is a bit of a shorter session today, so I'm going to cut it a little bit short and make sure I concentrate on those some of those really strong hints and tips that you can take away with the quick wins to help you get started with, because obviously all of you I'm guessing are probably at slightly different levels of proficiency using the product. So what we're going to cover then in the next 40 minutes or so. So I'm going to do a demo. I'm going to share my screen with you and show you how to get the most out of Compass Plus. As I say, we'll then look at some hints and tips for you to take away with. And then what I also wanted to do just before we go into that question and answer session is just to draw your attention to some training and resources. So some training modules we have available for you that are free that you can take now to help you get going using Compass Plus, and also some other resources. So when I talk to users who've recently upgraded to Compass Plus, I think really the key point to make is that for those of you who were using the old version of Compass, so Compass Classic as we call it now, the older version, the really big difference that you will experience by upgrading products is that you are moving to a tool that is a pupil data-driven tool. So it's fed from your school's MIS system. So it's linked into your Bromcom, your Sims, your Arbor, whichever system you use. And it's taking a basic data feed for your pupils from there. So that's a really, really key difference, because however powerful the tool is, as it's really data-driven, it's only going to be as powerful as the data that you enter into it. So when we come to look at this demo in a second, the things I'll be showing you, you'll see how if you're keeping the data up to date, you're going to get the most from it. Okay, because all the data intelligence that it can provide for you to help you with your careers program needs to be kept up to date as possible. So I'm going to take you through four things briefly now. So here are the four real general principles that we recommend to you when you are using Compass Plus. So just very quickly before we look at the product then. So firstly, we recommend that you're planning your careers program with clear objectives. So when you're using Compass Plus, you have your strategic objectives in mind that are relevant to your school. So all schools are going to be different and have different priorities. And Compass Plus can help you support those particular priorities. So you need to identify what those priorities are and use Compass Plus to support them. Secondly, reflecting pupil level aspirations. So as I said, it's a pupil data driven tool, and that it can help you to reflect those pupil level aspirations, particularly around destinations planning. And we'll have a look at that in a few minutes. And thirdly, Compass Plus can help you form part of a targeted careers program that addresses gaps. And what we mean by that is that it's a tool that's really set up to help you identify those particular cohorts, those particular individuals that might have particular needs, that might have particular interests, and you can use the data in Compass Plus to target them. And finally, there are a number of tools within Compass Plus to help you manage your providers, so to help you manage your providers that you work with. And we recommend that when you're creating activities, you're shaping them where you can with employers. So let's skip over to our demo. So all of you, I think, are on the call today will, as Leslie Ann said, are upgraded to Compass Plus. So here's your dashboard as we see it when you log in. What you won't see until you complete an evaluation is any data here. So this dashboard, which is a snapshot view of your careers program at the moment you took your last completed evaluation, won't have any data in it until you complete an evaluation. So we can't stress that highly enough. And it was mentioned at the beginning of the session that if you haven't done an evaluation recently, we recommend that you do one. And CEC recommends that you complete one once a term in order that you're keeping your data up to date. So just to have a look at some of the main features then of the dashboard here and how these help you achieve that first principle, planning with clear objectives. So we can see here that this first data visualization shows us a snapshot view of our progress towards completing the 8 Gatsby or achieving the 8 Gatsby benchmarks. And we can see that a couple here, for instance, say 5 and 7, have slightly lower scores than the rest of the benchmarks at this moment in time. And what you can do if you haven't explored this already, what you can do is immediately drill down further to see where those gaps lie. So if we go to the evaluation section and we look at your evaluations, just one thing to stress as we're looking at this demo, remember this is only my demo version. None of the data you're seeing here is actually from a real school. All the pupil data is dummy data. So we have a screen here where we can access all our previous evaluations. Ignore all these ones that are in progress. This is only because I'm doing lots of demos with people and starting evaluations and not completing them. But what you need to do is find your most recent completed evaluation. So within the academic year here, here's our completed evaluation. We have a series of options here. We can go in and view those results. So if we go in and review those results, these screens are brought across from Compass Classic. So you should be familiar with these from the older version of Compass. And if we go down the list, we can look at these in a bit more detail. So if we pick up benchmark 5 here that we saw on the dashboard, and we choose to drill down further, we can see that we haven't yet achieved this particular criteria, which is about having at least one meaningful encounter with an employer, and that we need to work on that. We need to work on that criteria in order to achieve the benchmark. So you can immediately see by using the dashboard screen how you can identify areas where you need to improve, where are there gaps in your program, and in order to increase the benchmark score for that area, you need to obviously create activities that support the benchmark 5. One thing that I'd also draw your attention to with this first data visualization is a couple of the couple of drop downs here that you might not have used yet. So the first one here allows us to compare evaluation with previous ones. So if we select previous evaluation here, this might be one that we've taken at the end of last term, for instance, we can see indicated by the dotted line here, how we have gone up or down for each of these benchmarks by the bar charts here, also tells us as a percentage and an arrow here. So it's a powerful tool for helping you quickly see what progress or otherwise that you've made. And if you're needing to report to your senior leadership team, I did a session yesterday, for instance, where Ofsted was in the area. This is up in Dudley area. And they were, a number of schools are saying they've had Ofsted there, and they've had to go into detailed explanation, provide detailed evidence for where they are with their careers program when challenged by Ofsted. So they were able to use this data that's provided to show the progress and the impact they're making. So you've also got here, if you've not used it already, if you click on generate report here, again, if you want to show this report to Ofsted or your member of your senior leadership team to show where you are in your careers program, you can see here, we have a nice PDF copy that you can print out and share with them. The second drop down here, which we urge you to use as well, is once you've started creating activities, you can use this second dropdown here to see what the potential impact of your activities are. So I know that I've got in this dummy school, I know that I've got a host of activities planned for the rest of the academic year. So I can see very quickly at the click of a button what the impact of those is going to be. So if I select here planned activities on the second drop down, I can see that of the activities that I've got planned for benchmark five, I'm going to see they're going to increase my score by 25% and help me complete that benchmark. So this is a really powerful tool here, using the second drop down to show what the impact of your activities are going to be. So again, you might be challenged by Ofsted, you might be challenged by senior leadership team. Okay, I know you've got loads of activities planned. How are these going to help us improve our benchmark scores? And we can see that very quickly by using that drop down. So that's the first principle that is useful to instill when you'll start. It's a good habit to get into when you start using Compass Plus. So taking evaluations regularly and making sure you're using the intelligence that the data intelligence it can provide to plan your activities. Okay, so moving on to the second principle. And as I said at the start, I appreciate I'm going quite fast here. If you do have any questions, pop them into the Q&A box or chat, and we'll try and cover them off at the end. So the second point is about reflecting pupil level aspirations. And go to the pupil level section here. We can see all our pupils in our current pupil list. And as most of you know, this is the way that the sector is moving. So we're moving towards asking schools to create activities purely at sort of group and larger sort of year group levels, and we're really starting to encourage schools to start individual pupil careers planning where they can, and Compass Plus has been developed to support that individualized approach to your planning. So how do we recommend that we do that? Well, there's lots of things you can do. I'm just going to concentrate on one today given the time we've got, and that's around interests and destinations. So you see we have our pupil list here. We've done some work on this, actually, some development work on this list recently. So this is all driven from your MAS system, from your SIMS, from your BROMCOM. And you can see actually now something that we've released recently is that this table view is actually customizable. So you can choose which columns you want to display on this table view here, and you can add or remove them as you see fit. You can add all the tick them as pupil premium, for instance. And once you've saved that as a filter, it will remain the next time you log in for Compass Plus. So you can set this screen up exactly how you want to see it the next time you log in. So let's look at an individual pupil profile. Let's look at Frank here. So we can see that Frank, again, just to note that these are all randomly generated names. So Frank is in year 9 here. He has 4 tabs, the first one being activities. We can see that all the activities that Frank has planned or completed, and the individual activities in a bit more detail. The second tab here is interests and destinations. So here is where you capture the interests and destinations for the people over time. Now, what we recommend is that you don't try and add all this information straight away for a pupil. We recommend that you build this information up for the pupil, capturing their thoughts, capturing their career's journey as they move through their career at your school. It's very, very detailed. There's no mandatory fields on here. So it isn't the case that once you start entering information, you then find you have to enter loads more data. You can start building this information up over time. So one thing we've just released, another improvement here, is that the subjects, industries, job roles, etc., you can set these all from predefined lists. We can select these things from lists if need be, but we can also now, you can type in individual new subjects if you like. So if Frank here is interested in coding, we can type that in ourselves as a new subject, and that will be retained within your database, and you'll be able to add that to another pupil if need be. So we recommend that you add these choices over time. If you can capture their destinations for where they want to go after Key Stage 4 and Key Stage 5. If you click on the plus here, that's the way you access all the further information about where they want to go next. So for in this instance, Frank wants to go to Abbey College in Malvern after Key Stage 4. We can capture all kinds of information here about the route that he wants to go down, duration of the course, whether he's had an interview, whether he's what his offer details are, etc., etc. And add all kinds of notes here as well. But again, you don't have to add that all, in one sitting. You can add that up over time, but so you make sure you're saving it as you do. The reason that's important, and that entering interests and destinations information is important. Obviously, you have your own reporting purposes, and they differ between schools in terms of who you have to report that destinations to. But once that destinations data is entered at an individual level, it also appears here on the dashboard. So if we scroll right to the bottom of these data screens here, you can see that we have destinations, a summary of the destinations data at an aggregate level. So we can pull up by year the intended destinations of the pupils and where they want, and the particular routes they are thinking of going down. Again, very useful for your reporting if you have to, if you're challenged by a member of SLT, for instance, or you have to provide reports about where your pupils are going next. And you can also, if you want to download all of that destinations data, you can choose to do it. You can do it here and download it all to a spreadsheet as well. So you can choose to download all that data or just download this filtered data here. So we recommend, as far as interests and destinations go, that you're updating that data little and often where possible, perhaps when you're having careers interviews with pupils, or whether in your school you're gathering that information in another way, and you can build up that information for the pupil over time, and that will feed into, say, key data stream about interests and destinations. So the third principle I wanted to draw your attention to is around targeting your provision to address gaps for particular cohorts and for particular pupils. And one particular tip that I would give you, if you have a particular need for this within your school, is to use what we call our custom group functionality. And if you haven't seen this already, you can access this through the Manage Groups menu here under Plans. So if we click on Manage Groups here, we can see all our group types, and we can filter them by group types, for instance. So we can look at forms, we can look at years, etc. Now, all these groups are fed directly from your management information system. So they're fed directly from your SIMS, directly from your BROMCOM, except custom groups. So if we select custom group type here, custom groups are the ones with black lozenges. And these are the only group type that you can create for yourselves as a Compass Plus user. So all the rest are driven by your MIS, the custom groups you create yourself. And the reason they're powerful is because they allow you to create a group that you can then sign to, create a custom group that you can then sign to activities. So just to give you an example, or some examples here, so we've created a number here. You can see that we've got particular interest groups. So we might have a smaller group of pupils drawn from year 10 that's just interested in technology. We might have a programming club. We might have a student council, for instance. So that student council might be drawn, so we've got 13 pupils in it here. That student council might be drawn from pupils across your school. So they might have pupils from year 8, year 9, year 12, for instance. And what you can do is very quickly, by clicking on create a new group here, is you can create a custom group. So we give the group a name, so year 9 coding club, and then we can go in and search for, we can start entering pupils individually, we can start entering a whole group, teaching group, and take pupils out of them and do it that way if we need be. So we can essentially create a customized group. And once you've created that group, once we've saved that custom group, you can very quickly attach them to an activity. So if we go up to plans, create a new activity, and we were, you know, we had a speaker coming in who was going to do a talk on introduction to coding. We'd give it a name, select a main benchmark category, fill in some other details there. But then we can search for a custom group for it. And in that instance, I would have already created my custom group, my year nine coding group of pupils interested in coding, and I would pull them up there very, very quickly. And if for example, I knew that one pupil, for instance, wasn't interested, Elsie here, not interested, we can take her out. So it's a very quick way of targeting provision at your pupils. So each school will have different priorities, and you might have these cohorts, these smaller groups, you think, we really need to create a specialized activity for these pupils. And you can do that very quickly within Compass Plus without needing to type in all the information each time. And you can just do it very quickly there at the click of a button. So that's the third principle. So it's about targeting where possible, targeting your provision to address those gaps for those particular interest groups or groups that might have particular needs. So the fourth principle I wanted to discuss was where possible to shape your activities with providers or with partners. And we have a number of tools within Compass Plus to allow you to do this. And so this is an area you might not have explored yet. So we call this your careers partners. So this is your database of your partners. So these might be local employers. These might be individuals who come in to do talks. These might be other organizations that run careers activities, careers interviews, careers dating, those kind of events. So they can come in. Once you've got the information from those organizations, you can enter them into your own database here. And this database here is unique to your school, so no other school can see it. Once they're in the database, you can easily pull them up within your activities and add them to an activity at the click of a button, in the same way as I just did for custom groups. So when you're creating activity, below the group section, there's a provider section. Once you start typing in a provider's name, they will appear here, and very quickly you can add them in without needing to type in any detailed information about the providers. And you can see that the details we have on file here, so we've captured all the information here about the organization, even right down to the individual levels and the kinds of activities that they are involved in. So there's a couple more tools, careers partner tools, that I haven't got time to go into today. One of them in particular is the Find an Activity Provider, which is useful for if you haven't got a provider who can help you deliver a particular activity within your school. Have a look at this directory here, and you can search by postcode, and it will suggest providers who can help deliver activities in your area. So that's a fourth principle, to shape activities with providers, with partners where possible. And there's a host of tools there within Compass Plus to help you do that. So just nipping back to our PowerPoint, conscious of the time here. So just to run over those four principles then. Don't worry about capturing all these details now. We can send this spreadsheet to you. But these are really four principles, as I said right at the beginning. They're about keeping in mind that Compass Plus is a data-driven tool, and that you can really use it in its most powerful way by keeping those data streams up to date. And by doing that, you can target those individual groups, you can target gaps in your, where you're not meeting benchmarks, and you can provide that evidence not only for your own benefit, but you can provide that evidence where needed for members of SLT, governors, if they need to see it, Ofsted, when they come in. Okay, so we'll look at some hints and tips. So I've put some up on the screen here. So the first one I think we've covered already. So when, you know, quite often when I speak to careers leaders and they say, oh, okay, I've had a look at their dashboard and I can see where I'm, you know, falling down on benchmark scores, I'm not sure then what to do. We looked at this earlier. So the first point here is you can go and drill down very quickly and see in your evaluation results where, what are those sub-criteria that you are not meeting? And they will give you a guide to the activities that you need to create to fill those gaps. That's the first point I'd make. The second tip was to save time by copying activities if needed. So if I go back to Compass Plus here, let's view our plan. So a plan, as you probably know, is where all our activities are kept. So let's view the plan for this year. Here are all our activities, marked as planned, completed, or cancelled. So what you can do, if you've created a particular activity, okay, and we've got this activity here for year 11, and imagine you said, oh, it would be great if we could run this business challenge day for year 12 as well, or year 10 as well. And all these providers say, yeah, they're absolutely happy to do come in and do that at the same time next week. What you can do is you can duplicate the activity. Okay, so you click on duplicate the activity, it'll ask you whether you want to go ahead, you duplicate it. Obviously, you'll just change the title then to year 10, year 12, whatever it is. And all the information there will be carried across. So you might need to obviously change the date, for instance, but it doesn't require you really typing in any information. So I would recommend that you duplicate those activities as well to save time. Another reason duplicating activities can be helpful is if you have an activity that you think is particularly well constructed, that you want to score against more than one benchmark. So if we haven't covered this before, but it's only the main Gatsby benchmark that the activity scores against. So if we wanted this activity to also score against benchmark 3, for instance, we could duplicate it, change the main activity, main category to benchmark 3, and it'll be entered in your plan as a separate activity and score against both benchmarks. So again, no need for you to enter all the data again. Yeah. So using duplicating activities, copying activities here is a useful tool. The third tip. So if possible, and I know most people probably have only upgraded very recently, but if possible, if you can start moving towards a whole school approach to careers planning, that's a really useful way of getting others to contribute towards your benchmark scores. So if you haven't done this already, so if you have, for instance, you might have a teaching assistant who helps you, or you might have a very keen member of teaching staff who possibly has a science teacher, for instance, who might have a friend who can come in and deliver talks about working in scientific research or something, and they want to create activities as well. Really easy to do so. Top right of the screen here, your options menu, user management. You can go in very quickly, create a new user within your school, enter some basic information about them, a job role and management level. The only bit I'm going to draw your attention to now is you need to choose what role you want them to have within Compass Plus. There's three different roles. The roles determine what you can and can't do in the product. So you might have someone who you don't want to be creating activities or just viewing data, for instance. But you might have someone who you want to be able to creating activities as well. Only the admin, so typically you as a careers leader, only an admin user can create other users. But once they're created as a user, if they're at least an editor, so an editor or an admin, they can create activities and start contributing to your benchmark scores. So it's obviously spreading that responsibility between between you and your colleagues for creating activities and contributing to benchmark scores. And the final tip is, I think, and we have touched on this already, which is around, you can provide SLT or Ofsted or Governance or other colleagues if need be with progress reports on your careers program by downloading those dashboard reports, also obviously individual pupil reports if need be, and exporting data. So you have a wealth of data there in terms of destinations, but also providers. So you can download all your providers, see where you have might have gaps in your industry coverage, and you can you can do that. And there's a wealth of data there that you can download. So there are a few quick tips. I'm just going to draw your attention to the training resources we have before we go on to questions. So firstly, there's our knowledge base. So quite often when you're using different websites, they have a help section. You click on the help section and you get sort of surrounding circles quite often. Or that's what I find. And quite often these help sections aren't particularly useful. What I will say within Compass Plus, and I know because I produce most of this stuff, is that the support via what we call our Compass Plus knowledge base is extremely detailed and comprehensive in Compass Plus. So if you're ever stuck and you don't know how to do something, rather than emailing in or giving us a call, the first thing I would urge you to do is click on the support widget here and search for what you're looking for. So if we search here, it comes up with a load of articles. Now, all these articles take you through a piece of functionality in really, really granular step-by-step detail. So you can see, if you're looking for a quick tip on how to do something, you can view it here within Compass Plus itself. Or if you want to watch a video, you can watch it outside of Compass Plus, and there'll be a video here explaining exactly what you need to do. And there's screenshots here, step by step as well. If you haven't got time, if you don't want to watch the video, typically those videos are a couple of minutes long, but they'll tell you exactly what you need to do. So I would urge you, if you haven't started using it already, it's really powerful and it's always here on the screen. Click on the support widget and accessing our Compass Plus knowledge base. The second thing, as I said at the beginning, is our training modules. So if we click on training resources here. Give it a second. Okay, so we have a couple of things here for you. Webinars. Obviously, you're on a webinar today. There's always more planned. We're in the process of planning more for after Christmas. So please feel free to sign up to one of our Compass Plus webinars. What we do on those is typically look at one section in particular detail, or quite often as well, we have other careers leaders speaking on them, explaining how they are using Compass Plus. The other thing is our online training. So this is free and available to you now. So you or any other colleague who's using Compass Plus can access this training. So we click on access training. It actually is launched from a separate platform called iHasco. What you do is you put in your email address, register, and you'll have access to a couple of online training modules. So they're all video driven. So there's videos in there, there's quizzes that check that that the knowledge has gone in. And at the end of those modules, you get a certificate. So you can show that you've achieved a level of proficiency in using Compass Plus. They take about 20 to 30 minutes each to complete. There's two of them, they're free. And I would urge you, if you're starting to use Compass Plus, please go in and take the training modules. You can complete them at your own pace, at slightly less of a pace than it as I've gone through today. So please go ahead and take those modules. Finally, you have access to your EC, your enterprise coordinators, and if you're in a CEC hub, your hub coordinator will also be able to answer questions about Compass Plus for you. If you can't find what you're looking for in the knowledge base or your EC can't help you, please feel free to contact the customer service team. You can also do that from within the support widget. So click on here. You can't find what you're looking for in here. Click on leave us a message. Type your message in here. It's got your email address in here. You can add a screenshot if need be, send, and one of our guys in the customer service team will contact you back, hopefully within 24 hours. So they're the sources of training and resources available to you. So I appreciate I've gone through that very, very quickly. Happy to take some questions now. So just give me a second and I'll try and...
I'll go through the chat if that's easier. So the first question we've had is around GDPR and about how the system uses student data. And there's concerns about whether the data is owned by pupils and is being inputted into a system and shared. So I wonder if you could just talk around that, please.
Yeah, so when the school signed up to Compass Plus, so presumably the person who raised that, their school's already signed up to Compass Plus. At the point of signing up to Compass Plus, the school's asked to sign up to particular terms and conditions, which explain exactly, and a privacy policy, which explain exactly how that that data is used. I haven't got time to go into all that now. What you can do, if you want to look at that retrospectively after you've signed up to that, we have a whole section here called how we use your data within the knowledge base. So if you go into Compass Plus, search for how we use your data, you can, it's all set out there, including FAQs there. You can read all that data. Obviously, you know, it's a fairly complex subject. I can't go into all the details now, but please go and have a look there. I'd say, as a school, you had to consent to, consent to these terms and conditions and privacy policy when you signed up. But you can access those details in retrospect. But these three articles here explain it in slightly more layman's terms for you. So I would urge you to go and have a look at those articles and they will explain that.
Brilliant. And it's already been raised in the chat, but some people have already commented that the student data that is captured during one-to-one careers interventions in that student profile, there is a option to tick that the students have given consent for them to be tracked and their email, etc., to be stored on the system. So you can utilise that section as well. Another issue that has been raised is there's been a couple of comments that they feel like the speed of the system is a little bit slower than it ideally should be.
That's interesting. I would say if that is the case, please contact the customer support because that's a technical issue. One of our customer service team should get back to you, investigating that within 24 hours. If you don't get a response to that, please contact your EC. Sporadically, we get one or two comments like that. They never seems to be widespread, and I've not had a. It's not been reported this week at all for anything that I've seen. But please, if you do have a comment, if it is acting slow for you in any way, we need to investigate that and make sure it's not a problem with your, and find out whether it's a problem with Compass Plus itself, or whether it might be something to do with your school network or the way that it's set up with your school, or one of our customer service team will be able to investigate that for you. So please contact them.
Brilliant. So Louise Davis has also commented that when they're pulling pupil reports, their report is only showing some of the year groups and not all of the year groups, and wondering what this issue is. Is that something for Compass Plus support?
Yeah, I'm assuming that is on the is that exporting data to Excel rather than exporting to rather than viewing the PDF report. Either way, it sounds like a technical error to me. So it's not something that I've heard before. I would you contact customer support, and again we can check whether that is an error within Compass Plus, or whether it's might be to do with the way that your school is feeding data through from your MIS system, for instance.
Brilliant. So the next query is about adding activities. They've added activities with set dates and interested about when those activities will go, show as completed. Is that an automatic thing or do you have to manually?
No, you have to manually do it. So if I go to your plan here, so I hope you can still see the screen. So I'm going to go into our plan and let's select an activity, this one, for instance. If you can see here, you have an option here to mark activity as complete. So when I click that, if I click that, it will move into the completed activities.
Yeah. Okay, brilliant. So next question, this is about a school has a subscription, but the previous admin person has left and no one else seems to know how to access Compass. I assume, again, Compass support can help with that.
Yeah, we do get one or two I mean, that does happen now and again. So please contact the customer service team. They will sort it out. It's obviously that is a good reason actually why, and we started to recommend this now, that you have more than one person registered within Compass Plus, because if one person does leave, it means that you have someone who can still access the system. I mean, if they can't, you end up with a problem as you just mentioned, then you'd have to contact customer support. But it's usual to have, it'd be good if you've got more than one user in there, so you've got that continuity.
Brilliant. I have a question in regards to pupil absence. So obviously when you tag a group, etc., in an activity, that threads through to individual student profiles that then can be printed, and it says this student had this activity on this day.
Yes.
If that student is absent on that day, yes, and they're noted as absent on Sims or yes, whatever system you're using, does that automatically mean that they won't be tagged with that activity?
Yes.
Brilliant.
If, for instance, it doesn't appear, it might be a problem to do with the MIS connection. So I get in touch with customer support. But that is the way it works.
Thank you so much. We've got like 1 minute left. Has anyone got any other last question they want to squeeze in, or wrap it up there? No, I think that's safe to say that's covered. So Struven, is there anything else from you, or you happy with?
I don't think so. I hope you've been able to see me. I see me at that end as you go through the questions there. I have got my video on, but I can't actually see myself. So I can see you,
Struven.
I hope you're not seeing my ear or top of my head or something. Only to just say thank you again. Thank you for attending the session today. And what I would really stress is, please go ahead. If you have started using the system, please consider taking those two training modules, because they're really basic. They're video driven. You know, that it's not just reams of text. It's videos that show you what to do. There's quizzes at the end of them. You get a certificate. And once you've done them, you know, I would say it's kind of 40, 45 minutes commitment. You'll feel in a much better place to get the most from Compass Plus, and they're free. You can sign up now, and it's really easy to go through those. So yeah, that's the only other thing, I think, sort of directing everybody to the training and spreading the word about that.
Brilliant, wonderful stuff. Thank you so much for joining us today, Struven. Really, really appreciate the support. If anyone else has any follow-up questions, send them through to, you know, your EC or to me at Careers Hub at growthplatform.org, and we will get them answered for you. Just for those who are late on, could we just kindly request that you complete your Compass submission before the end of term, before you break up. If you've got any questions about your Compass evaluation, send them through to your enterprise coordinator, and they will support you on that front. A recording will be sent out of this. I'll send it out tomorrow, so you can share with staff if you need to, or you can review it again. Okay.
Yeah, and we've also got that session at 11, haven't we? So I'm doing another session at 11. So I don't know if the same people might be invited to that session.
Yeah. So this is about integrating Compass Plus with other platforms such as Unifrog, Zello, those kinds of systems. So if you are interested in finding out more about that, there is an 11 a.m. session as well.
Yeah. So I might see some of you then. Yeah.
So thank you all for joining. See you soon.
Bye. Thanks everyone. Bye-bye.